The pre-shorts test usually includes tests for devices such as potentiometers, jumpers, and switch settings. These tests are executed first because the position of these devices usually affects the shorts and opens testing. Click on the Shorts category under the Test Explorer. Select the Shorts test. Click Run. And review the results. In this case, there is a Shorts test failure as seen in the output panel. As highlighted there, there is a through short between the nodes fault TP6 and fault TP7. Caused by a closed jumper on the board, common device J143. In this case, users are able to add the two nodes from the drop-down node list. Click on OK afterwards. New shorts will then be added to the test list. Click on Run after adding the shorts. After executing the test, users can see that the first short between nodes TP6 and TP7 has disappeared. However, there is still another short between node $8N210 and CPLD flash status. In order to debug the short, search and filter the node $8N210 as shown on the screen. Change the threshold of the node from 1K to 16 ohms. After rerunning the test with this change, you can notice the node $8N210 disappear from the shorts list. The node CPLD flash status still has a failure as highlighted in the output panel. Filter the node again and change the threshold from 1K to any value below 769 ohms. After making all the necessary adjustments to the shorts test, the test has now passed. Then, run N times to check the stability of the test.